Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I just bought a football team. No, it's not the Gators. That's a public university. You can't buy them. And no, it's not the NFL. Can't afford to buy an NFL team. But I did buy into the FCF League. FCF stands for fan-controlled football. So the FCF League, fan-controlled football, it's a new football league that's very similar to the Arena League, but it has a special twist. In this league, you can actually, one, you can become an owner like I just did, but you can also call plays and you can draft the players each week. And so you can think of this as kind of a Madden franchise mode brought to real life, to where you have actual real life people who you call the plays for and you can watch them play as well. And so you may be thinking, AJ, what does this have to do with investing? What does this have to do with personal finance? So as an owner of a team, this is essentially an alternative investment. Now, an alternative investment is anything that you invest in that's not your typical equity investment. So most people, when they think about investments, they think about investing in the stock market. But an alternative investment could be purchasing Bitcoin, although some people don't consider Bitcoin an actual investment because it's meant to be a currency. But other alternative investments are real estate is an alternative investment, gold and silver are alternative investments, and investing in startups is another way to invest in alternative investments. And so in this video, not only am I going to tell you about the FCF League and why I invested, but I'll also tell you about how, if you would like to, you can invest in this league as well, or other alternative investments just like the FCF League. And so going into more details about the FCF League, again, this is the fan-controlled football league. And so anyone that signs up for the fan-controlled football league, you don't actually have to purchase or become an owner in order to participate. If you just want to participate and you want to watch the games, you want to participate in the game calling, you can just sign up on their website at fcf.io. And yes, even if you're not an owner, when you sign up to watch the league or to sign up as a participant, you can actually choose one of the four teams that's currently available. And once you're on that team, you can then vote for all of the offensive plays that your team has. And so there are currently only four teams. The team that I joined or became a part owner of is Team Beast. There's also Team Glacier Boyz, Team Zappers, and Team Wild Aces. And you can choose to become part of any of these teams and essentially not only be an owner, but you can be the GM because they have a weekly draft, and you can be the coach because you get to call the offensive plays. And so currently this league, it actually started last week. February 13th was the first game, and the games are live streamed on Twitch. For those of you who may not know, Twitch is a platform that you can use for live streaming. It is very popular amongst gamers, people who play games live and they would like other people to watch it. But it's not only for gamers, it's for pretty much anything that you want to live stream. And so for gamers who are already used to watching other people play games on Twitch, now you can actually kind of be a participant in real live play. So these are actual people playing football that you get to pick the plays. So if you've ever played Madden or NCAA, they have their franchise mode where you can draft your players, you can choose the plays, you can essentially be the coach of the team. Well, now you can do this basically in real life. You can be the owner, you can be the GM, you can be the coach, and you can do this all while live streaming with other people who are also participating and watching these events. And so in order to become an owner, FCF League partnered with the startup investing website Republic, and for as little as $150, you can become a part owner of any of the four teams. And actually, technically, you can invest in all four teams if you want to, but as I mentioned, full disclosure, I invested in Team Beast, so of course I'm rooting for Team Beast to be successful, or at least to win the championship or championships. But overall, because I am an investor in the company, I want the entire league to succeed as a whole. And a few of the main reasons I invested in the FCF League, coming from an actual investor's perspective, was the fact that they have a lot of big name sponsors and big name individual investors. And so I'll go through that list of sponsors as well as the individual investors that made me want to actually take part in investing in this league. And so the major sponsor, of course, I mentioned that Twitch, this is where the games are live streamed so that you can watch them online. And if you don't know, Amazon owns Twitch. So that means that Amazon themselves, they would love for the FCF League to be a big hit. And in fact, 91% of all video game streaming is done on the Twitch platform. That means Facebook and YouTube and many of the other live streaming platforms, they're only taking up the other 9% of all video game streaming. And so Amazon slash Twitch, they are well versed at being able to stream these types of live events. But not only that, they're also used to live streaming actual NFL football games. And so for the last couple of years, Amazon has actually had streaming rights for the NFL's Thursday night football games. Now, while they didn't have exclusive rights to all of the Thursday night football games, they are currently actually working on trying to be the exclusive owner of the Thursday night games. And so that means in the future, if they come to an agreement with the NFL, they will stream all of the Thursday night football games, versus in the past where maybe Fox or CBS may have had certain games throughout the year on those Thursday nights. And so Amazon also has AWS, which is the Amazon Web Services, which is their cloud infrastructure platform. So they're used to supporting many different companies and their online initiatives through AWS, as well as for gamers through the Twitch platform. And so, of course, if this were to succeed, Amazon would be a great beneficiary of the growth of the league. And so they really want this to succeed. And so this is one of the reasons why I felt this is probably going to be a good investment. Now, the next company, which is Verizon, is not only a sponsor for the league, but they're actually equity owners as well. And Verizon is considered the mobile leader, or the leader in mobile cell phone service. Now, T-Mobile and AT&T, they may have their own arguments about that, but with 5G service and just general network coverage, Verizon is usually at the top. They're in the lead. And so with a league like this, where you're going to be live streaming, you're going to be interacting with the fans by allowing them to pick plays, you're going to need a strong network in order to connect not only the fans to the field and to the coaches in order so that they can receive the plays, but also to all of the devices that they're using in the actual stadium. So they have drone cameras, they probably have other IoT devices that have to have network connectivity, and they're going to use the Verizon network in order to support those different devices. And so not only as a sponsor of the league, but also an investor, Verizon has an incentive to try and help this league become something bigger than it currently is. Now, the next sponsor is IBM, specifically IBM Watson. Watson is their artificial intelligence platform. And if you've ever played fantasy football on ESPN, you know that IBM Watson has certain features within the ESPN app that allows you to get different insights about either your individual players or potentially making trades with other people in your fantasy league. And so they're providing some of the same types of features that they do for ESPN in the fantasy app in the real live sessions or selections within the games with the FCF league. And so when you're picking plays in the FCF league, they actually give you probabilities on the percentage or the likelihood that the next play or the play that is selected will actually score a touchdown. Now, of course, the humans have to actually play the game, but you know, depending on the position that they're at on the field, of course, the closer you are to the touchdown, the higher the probability that the play that you run is going to score a touchdown. But also, they probably give you insights as far as how successful the previous plays were. There are only a small set of plays that you can actually select. And again, you have to actually vote for the play that's going to be selected or the play that's going to be ran by your team that you vote for. And based on whatever play gets the most votes, that's the play that's actually going to be ran on the field. And so I'm interested to see how this is going to fit or how IBM Watson is going to affect the gameplay of FCF. And that will be seen as there's only been one game played so far. And so we'll see what happens with that. But it's really nice to have a large company like IBM sponsoring a new startup league just like this. And so the next sponsor, Progressive Insurance. They are also a major company. Of course, Progressive Insurance, they provide car insurance and as well as other types of insurance to individuals. And so as a sponsor, during each game, they have specific segments where they include Progressive. And so one of the interesting things about the FCF League, or one of the features that was voted on by the fans, was to have a fifth down. And of course, they call this the Progressive fifth down. And with the fifth down, after you have a fourth down, you actually can vote at least, I believe it's only one time per game, but you can actually vote to have a fifth down. So let's say it's the end of the game, it's fourth down, you're down less than a touchdown, and you don't get a first down on the next play, then you can actually use this as a fifth down in order to get an additional play, giving you an additional chance to score points in the actual game. And so if it's a close game and you don't have that much time left, this is a time that you probably want to use that fifth down. Now, there's another section that's also sponsored by Progressive. It's called FCF Protection. And this is where they actually speak to the offensive linemen in the game. Because if you know anything about football, then you know the offensive line is essentially the insurance for the quarterback in your league. Their job is to protect the quarterback, make sure that they don't get hit, or at least not hit too often or hit too hard. And so they named this segment FCF Protection so that they can highlight the offensive linemen in the league. Now, if you've watched NFL, you probably don't know too many offensive linemen by name, or certainly probably not by face. And so this is a great way to include those players who are normally people you don't hear a lot about in the NFL or Canadian leagues or other football leagues. And last but not least, there's a third section called Outstanding Coverage. And of course, you think about, you know, your life insurance coverage or your car insurance coverage. And so that's, you know, a play on words to talk about outstanding coverage. And that's when they talk about the defensive play of the game or multiple defensive plays. That's when they talk about it in the FCF coverage segment. And so again, as a large insurance provider, as a sponsor of the FCF league, they have an incentive to help and make this league grow. And next is the company Champion. Champion is the uniform provider for the FCF league. Some of you may already wear Champion gear, whether it's shoes, socks, t-shirts, other jerseys from other leagues. Champion is mostly known for their athletic gear. And Champion is owned by Hanes Brands, as well as the other companies that I mentioned in this video. They are all publicly traded companies. And so again, as a sponsor of the league, Champion / Hanes Brands and all of these companies, which are actually publicly traded companies that you could invest in individually, all of these companies are looking for the FCF league to be successful, to not only make money for the companies that are actual investors, but as sponsors, they would get more exposure the more people that actually watch the games. And so of course, with any advertisement, they're looking for people who are watching the league to actually purchase their products, because they're going to see the names of these companies over and over again as they're watching and interacting with this sports league. And so there are a few other companies as well, like Wendy's, Gatorade, and a few others listed here. I got a little graphic with all of the sponsors that show up on their website. But not only are there large companies that are sponsors and invested into the FCF league, but there are also well-known individual investors as well. And so at the beginning, I forgot to mention that there are actually some former players and other celebrities who are actually investors in some of these individual teams. So like with Team Beast, which is the team that I joined, Marshawn Lynch, who is known as Beast Mode, he's an owner of the Beast teams. So of course you can see where they got their name from, Beast Mode, Team Beast. But there are also some very notable individual investors who are invested not only just in an individual team, but in the league as a whole. And so Joe Montana, a former Hall of Fame QB, he is an investor in the FCF league. Alexis Ohanian, who was the co-founder and former CEO of Reddit, he is an investor in the league. Dave Finocchio, who is the co-founder and former CEO of Bleacher Report. Ferran Soriano, he is the CEO of the Premier League's Manchester City FC team, as well as the New York City FC team, which is part of the MLS. And there's also Victor Font, who is the CEO of Delta Partners, and he's also the lead candidate to be the president of FC Barcelona. And I'm going to destroy this man's name, but Mark Teluzix, I'm going to have it on the screen so you can actually read it. He is the co-founder and CEO of Mangrove Capital, as well as the chairman of Wix.com. And Wix.com, for those who don't know, that is an actual website where you can actually help you build your own website. So if you have a personal website, Wix.com is a website that you can use to build your own website. And Wix.com is also a publicly traded company. And then on a lower level, there are some celebrities. I'll have a post that shows, you know, all of the owners of the individual teams, or at least all of the big name owners that they're showing on their website. And so once you take a look at all of the sponsors, You look at the big companies that are invested. You look at the big individual names that are invested in the league. And then you even look at the individual team owners that have big names like Marshawn Lynch and Mike Tyson, and even players. They actually have Johnny Manziel, who's actually a former NFL player. He's actually participating in the league, and I'm pretty sure he probably has some form of an ownership stake as well. And so once you mix all of the big sponsors, all of the individual investors, this is something that all of these people have an incentive to try and make this league work and be very successful. Now, of course, it can't be a success without actually having fans coming out or going online or going on their phone and watching the games and participating. But one of the reasons I do think that it will be successful is that the growth of not only sports over the past couple of decades, but also the growth of esports. And so people watch other people play video games online, and these aren't actual people being involved. And so you have a mix of actual physical sports with people who are doing esports or, you know, watching gaming online, and you have that all combined into one league where it's esports, it's gaming, it's an actual people that are playing the game, and you kind of get the feel of a Madden or an NCAA franchise mode. And so their hope, as well as my hope, is now being an investor into the league and into Team Beast. Our hope is that the league will actually grow over time, and that, you know, maybe down the road there will probably be some type of return on my investment. And so unlike the stock market, where you can immediately see the gains that you have on a day-to-day, week-to-week, year-to-year basis, and if they pay dividends, then you can get paid every month or every quarter, depending on how often they pay dividends. When you're investing in an alternative investment, or especially in a startup specifically, you don't get that same immediate feedback or that immediate return that you can see by just opening your investment app and looking at how the value has changed from day to day. And so that's what I'll talk about next, just generally talking about startup investing and the Republic website, which allowed you to invest in the FCF League. So at least for now, if you were to actually use, and I'll put a link in the description below, you can actually become an owner or a part owner of one of the four teams in the FCF League. Currently, the team that I've already joined or become an owner of, Team Beast, they've already reached their limit for the amount of money that they're raising for that individual team. Each team has a maximum of $265,000 on the Republic website, where you can actually invest in these individual teams. And at the recording of this video, Team Beast has already reached its maximum, but the other three teams have not, just as of yet. But speaking about startup investing in general, in the past, individual investors or non-accredited investors weren't able to invest in private companies. You could only invest in public companies through the stock market, like most of the things that I talk about on my channel. But as part of the 2012 Jobs Act, President Obama signed legislation that would allow the average Joe, or, you know, the 98% of Americans, to actually invest in companies that have not gone public yet. So in the past, you had to be an accredited investor, which are people who are, you know, the 2% most wealthiest people in the United States. In order to be an accredited investor, you have to have a certain amount of wealth. You have to have a certain amount of income in order to qualify to be an accredited investor. But now, after the Jobs Act, or after this specific legislation, which is called the REG-CF, CF standing for crowdfunding, now the average Joe is able to invest in startups via websites like republic.co and other startup websites, which I'll talk about in the future the more I talk about startup investing. And so since 98% of people in the United States are not accredited investors, when I do talk about startup investing in the future, most, if not all, of the websites that I will talk about, you will be eligible to invest in it. But each individual person will have a certain limit that they can invest in based on their net worth. And so just like you, I'm not an accredited investor. I'm not in the top 2%, or at least not yet, of wealthy people in the United States. And so I want to help you and myself by learning more about these startup websites and potentially investing in more startups just like the FCF Football League. And so if you'd like to get started with startup investing, I'll have my referral link to the Republic website, as well as a link to the different teams that are available to invest in for the FCF League if you're interested in actually investing in one of those teams. But even if you're not interested in investing in the FCF League, you may be interested in many of the other businesses, the many other startups that are available on the Republic website. So make sure you check out their website. Even if this specific thing isn't something you want to invest in, there may be something else that you're willing or interested in supporting that's available on their website. But as far as the FCF League, the season has already started. Their first game was played on February 13th. And so if you're interested and you'd like to learn more about the FCF League, I'll have a link to their website as well, so that even if you don't want to be an owner and you just want to watch or you want to participate, you can join and you can be a participant. You can start picking plays. You can start helping with the weekly drafts each week, or with picking the one franchise player that will always be on your team as long as they are the franchise player for the individual team that you support. So let us know what you think about not only the FCF League, but also the opportunity to invest or to own part of a football team or a part of a sports league in general. Also, let us know what you think about Republic and investing in startups. If you've used Republic before, let us know maybe something that you've already invested in using the Republic website. Or if you haven't invested in a startup, maybe you just found out that this is something that you can actually do, or maybe it's something you are already interested in but just haven't gotten started. This is one website that you can use. And in the future, I'll talk about some of the other websites that you can use in order to invest in startups. And if there are any websites that you have used or that you prefer versus Republic, leave that in the comment as well so that others can learn more about how they can get started with investing in startup companies, companies that are currently private, not public, companies that you can invest via the stock market. All right, thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below, hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video just like this. All right, thanks again. Have a great day.